Okay, yes, we back. Another crazy wild man cave week in the building. As you know, we chop it up how we do in the man cave. We got a very, I'll say, interesting topic brought to us tonight that we're going to dive right into. You know, I'm going to, in honor of Gator, you know, Gator got some things he like to get off his chest, you know, like to talk to some people. And y'all know I'm always ready for the smoke. So with that being said, welcome to another wild and crazy edition of the Man Cave. I'm your host, Cal Williams, and I'm joined by my co-host, Gator himself. You know, Mr. Tone Deaf is in the back office, you know, signing some checks and locking in some sponsors so we can always keep the lights on and keep things moving as we do always. So shout out to Tone, brother. We might see Tone a little later, you know, and you know the young boy, young gunner, young fresh. He's always out securing that bag. So shout out to Young Fresh, too. It's me and Gator in here tonight. So my fellow cave brother, Gator, what's good, man? Talk to me. It's a lot here. It's a lot going on with you.
What's up, man? You know what?
Okay.
It's not a lot going on. I was just messing with people, you know. I wanted to see what was going to happen.
Yeah.
So,
yeah. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
No, go ahead.
No, I was going to say, but you know, in the midst of you messing with people, you know, I hear some people got a little emotional. You know, I hear some people got in their feelings. You know, I heard, you know, some things were said. So, you know, you putting it out there, expressing yourself, being the instigator that you are, you know, and I hear some people got in their feelings. I mean, like, what's that then drawed up tonight's topic? I mean, talk to us, brother. What's going on?
Man, it was simple, bro.
Mm-hmm.
All I did was say, I saw this post, and I was like, oh, that'd be good. Let me see what happened. You know, we always talk about women and how they can't admit that they wrong, and they want to take responsibility for wrongdoings, but they want us to do it all the time.
Oh yeah,
you ain't
a
man if you ain't saying it. You ain't a man if you ain't doing. So
yep, sounds familiar. Sounds very familiar.
The post just said, "Ladies, repeat after me. I was wrong, and I'm sorry."
Mm-hmm.
That was the whole post. So
you know what?
These comments, dog.
Yeah.
First comments I got was, I'm sorry you was wrong. I'm sorry you was wrong. What? I said, really? That's what? Another one.
Okay.
He was wrong, and he's sorry.
Wow. Okay.
Another one said, I was wrong about thinking that person was sincere. I'm sorry. I'm saying to myself.
Wow. Okay, so we're gonna jump into these comments one by one. Was it more comments made?
Bruh, I got this post that I posted.
We gonna jump into these comments one by one. For those just tuning in that's not sure what we're talking about, or maybe came into the middle and didn't really catch the beginning. Well, you know, I mean, I didn't go in and say the exact topic as of yet, but anybody listening, you know, could really catch on where we're about to go with this. But just to put it out there, tonight's topic, in honor of my brother Gator, is women. Repeat after me. I was wrong, and I'm sorry. Period.
That's all.
Period. That's it. Women, repeat after me. I was wrong, and I'm sorry. Period. Why is it so hard for women to admit when they are wrong? This is what we're talking about tonight. Yes. Yes, this is what we're talking about. It's that simple. It's that simple.
The way they took it was like I cussed them out.
No. You know why? Because in their eyes, you did. What you mean I'm wrong? I mean, look, it's not rocky. Look, it's just nothing new to any man walking this earth. women always feel that they're right.
Yeah.
That's just like any man that had a woman, a girlfriend, a female best friend, a side chick, a jump off, a one night stand, any woman that's been encountered, any man that's been encounter of any woman can agree with this. Women, you know, women feel that they always right until proven wrong. And then even when proven wrong, they still right. They still find a way to justify why they're wrong. You know, and why, I'm sorry, I said that completely wrong. Women do feel that they, you know, they always right and until proven wrong. And even when proven wrong, they still find a way to justify why they're not wrong or why they're only a portion wrong, and then they're right in this area. They don't just own up to being completely wrong. You know, they fucked up, my bad. Like, and I'm going to even take it a step further, and I'm not going to say all women, because there is a 5%. Yes, 5%. I'm not even going to say 10, because I haven't met that many that will. So, and you know, in my life, I haven't. Maybe somebody else out there, maybe another man has, and they could say 10% or 20%. I can't. There's a good 5% that will completely admit their wrongs.
Is it 5% though? Damn.
That's high. Okay. See, I said 5. Gator feel that number's kind of high.
I'm just saying.
What would you say? What would be your percent?
I'm going to put it to you this way.
Okay, talk to me.
I posted this in 3 groups.
Mm-hmm.
On my personal page.
Mm-hmm.
And out of probably 30, 40 people posted, women saying something, one woman said, I can admit when I'm wrong. One.
Mm. Wow. 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 So that's not even 5%. That ain't even 5%. That's actually 1%. That's actually 1%. One woman out of 3 different groups.
If it's one woman, I mean...
Ladies, what's going on? You're looking bad out there, ladies. You're looking bad. My Gator posted this comment, and I'll repeat the comment for those that's just tuning in. Ladies, repeat after me. I was wrong, and I'm sorry. That's the comment, word for word. Gator posted this comment in 3 different groups.
That's the post.
In 3 different groups, only one woman responded and said, I can admit when I'm wrong. 3 different groups. Ladies, you're looking bad out there. You're looking bad. I'm going to be honest with you. You're looking bad out there, ladies. You're looking bad. I mean... This right here just shows how it proves our point as far as not taking accountability, not owning up to your wrong. It proves our point that so many men has said and so many men has argued, you know, so many men have debated. It proves our point. This was a test, whether you know it or not. This was an experiment. And you proved us right.
And one of the ladies said she apologized to a dude once. And she thinks she broke him because he was speechless. She said, I guess he was expecting a debate.
I said, well, duh. Wow.
And saying he was right? What?
I mean, any man would have been speechless. Listen, we're never right. So if you telling me I'm right, Whoa. Like, I don't have nothing else to say. You telling me I'm right? For one, you know damn well anytime the 5%, that's what I'm gonna call it from now on. Yeah. That's what I'm gonna refer to it now as, the 5%. Anytime the 5% tell a man that, you know what, babe, you right. The first thing we do is we repeat that shit back to them, because we don't even believe they said that. We like, we want them to hear it again for a second time, just in case, you know, and, you know, yeah, you, hold on. Did you just say that I'm right? Then we pause and wait for them to say it a second time. We need more confirmation.
We need a confirmation.
We need confirmation. Like, we repeat it back for confirmation. Like, maybe that was a slip up. Maybe she didn't mean to say that. She probably don't even know she said that. Like, was that the right thing that she just said? And as soon as we get the confirmation.
Yeah, no idea.
We like, oh, okay, yeah. Now we get a little cocky. Yeah, see, I told you I was right. You see what I'm saying? You didn't believe it, but okay, that's what's up. All right, yeah, see, because I was right, babe. I was right. We say that shit like about 5-6 times just because we never right. So we want to make sure that everybody know we right. Oh, my gosh. There you go. We want to put that out there.
I was at least right once.
Mm-hmm. Now, remember back in August 17th? It was around about 8:30 at night. I remember it was 8:30 at night because you was in the kitchen. You know, you had just put something in the microwave. You know what I'm saying? I came downstairs, you know, I was watching the game, and I came downstairs and I asked you, you know, did we have more chicken, you know what I mean, in the refrigerator? And you going to say to me, no, we didn't have more chicken, we had steak. And I'm like, no, babe, we didn't have steak, we had chicken, because I remember, you know, you made the steak with the potatoes, you made chicken with, you know what I'm saying, with the mac and cheese. You know, and then you went in the fridge and you looking and you know, you beefing at me, telling me, oh, I don't know what you cooked. Oh, I don't appreciate you. This, that, you know, oh, you slave over a stove, and how I can forget that it was steak, and steak is my favorite. And oh, I must not care about you making my favorite. You argued with me for about a good 10, 15 minutes. I remember that. I started to feel bad. But then I remember, why am I feeling bad? Because I know we had chicken and not steak. So,
I know it.
Then you went in the refrigerator, and then you pulled, you know, you pushed the food to the side. The chicken was in the back right next to the milk. And then you realized, and I knew you was wrong, because you had that silly look on your face like, oh, shit, I fucked up, you know. So then you came out and you said, oh, yeah, babe, we got chicken. You remember that? August 17th, 8:30. I remember that. See what I'm saying? That's how. It is sad I was able to just break that shit down like that, but that's how we be when we write.
We be knowing the time, the date, what was said.
Everything. Like, everything.
One of the women on my page said, oh my, and I was like, these comments. She said, yeah, exactly. She was like, I didn't know y'all had it that bad. Like, this ain't nothing new.
Nothing new.
Wrong.
Yeah. Ain't nothing new. We get used to, we get numb to being wrong. We wrong all the time. We be like, yeah, okay, all right, babe. No problem.
Like, you never have to get it. Never mind. No, tell me what you were going to say. Nah, it's good.
It's good. It's all right. I'm wrong. Yeah, it's okay. It's all right.
I would just cut out the middle, man. Don't even try it. Don't, yeah.
Wow. Wow.
We got witnesses and everything. Like, yeah, he was telling
still
me,
wrong.
Never mind. Don't even try. Don't worry about it.
It gets so bad that they convince the witnesses that you have that you might be wrong. The witnesses that's there to back you up start second guessing you. Like, you know what? You know what? You might be wrong. She might be right, man. Because I was like, ain't you here for me? You're supposed to be helping me. Get caught up into that shit, Jedi mind trick. Don't get caught up into that.
I'm just saying, man. I don't even try no more.
Yeah, man.
I just give it up.
And see, that's the problem, man. Like, we be knowing we right. And because we don't want to hear it, we just...
ain't want no problems.
We just say, fuck it. You know what? Fuck it. Fuck it. I'm wrong. Yeah, I'm wrong.
You're right. You know, like, of course.
Doesn't mean... Like...
And then they get mad because we won't talk about it.
No, because then they right.
Why you?
Because I know I'm right. I don't want to talk about this bullshit as far as like how you, I'm wrong, you feel I'm wrong. And when I know I'm right, I don't want to talk about this shit. Don't bring it up. I don't want to talk about it. That's the problem. But see, you know what? This issue with women always feeling they right, it starts from young. It starts from young, and I'm gonna tell you why. I'm gonna tell you how it starts from young. When you have a little sister, and I'm gonna start with the little sister first. When you have a little sister, and you're the older sibling, your father always tell her, "Give your little sister what she want. Give her the toy. Mm-hmm. Just give it to her. She could be damn wrong. It could be your toy. It could be your favorite G.I. Joe with the kung fu grip. Your favorite man. You play with him all the time.
Just because they don't hear her mouth."
There you go. Just because they don't want to hear her mouth. Give it to her. Give it. Dad, this is my toy. Like, she don't even play with G.I. Joes. She don't even play with them. She got her Barbies. Give her the toy. Why can't I give her my toy? But this is my toy. Give it to her. Then she start whining. No. Before she start whining, then she go over to your father and tell your father that you won't give her your toy. How wrong does that sound right there? You see what I'm saying? That right there spells out wrong. There's nothing right about that situation. But what do your father do in return? Or mother, in that fact? Just give her the toy so she can be quiet? No, that's not the right thing to do. So therefore, they grow up feeling, even when they're wrong, they're right. And all they got to do is get loud. Or start screaming or start crying because this is the same things they've been doing since a little girl that worked and mommy and daddy gave them their way. And they learned that throughout growing as a young lady, all they got to do is get loud, get emotional, or start screaming or crying, and it will get them their way.
Yep. Every time.
And this is why. We just broke down the whole scientific facts right here. These are scientific facts on how women and why they feel. Now women, once little girls, once young women, little girls to young women, grown women, why they feel they always right. It starts from young. Blame the parents. It's the parents' fault, see? It's the parents' fault.
It's brought on to the next generation because the next do it. They do it. Or my parents do it. I'm do it too.
That's right. They teach their daughters the same techniques. They teach their daughters the same thing. And it just continue on. So the next time you get mad at your woman that's feeling she always right, call her parents. Call her parents.
Yep.
Have a conversation with her parents. They started this. They started the bullshit. They started the bullshit. Yeah, they did. They started the bullshit.
Absolutely.
Damn shame. It's a damn shame. I'm sorry, fellas. I'm sorry. Now let's get back to these comments with these women. Let's go into this. What was the first two comments after you posted that, Gator?
The first two comments was
Yeah, let's go
into
this.
She said, "I'm sorry, you was wrong."
I'm sorry, you was wrong. So she just straight ignored the whole comment. See that? You see that right there?
I said, "You can't do it, huh?" She said, "I tried the best I could."
look, see? Her best wasn't even good at all. Her best was awful. She ignored the whole statement and jumped right into, "I'm sorry, he was wrong." What? That's not even what the statement says. The statement says nothing about him being wrong.
nothing.
Just automatically ignored the whole thing.
I don't understand.
Once proven. Then, go ahead.
You're right. No, continue.
Just once proven our fact of a woman not being able to admit when she's wrong and take accountability for her being wrong and actually giving a sincere apology. That right there was sarcasm and just straight disregard for what you even said. Oh my. Oh my. Oh my. Oh my. Yeah.
So wow. Next comment. The next
what's the next? Let's move on to the next comment.
The next one said, he is wrong and I'm sorry. No, she said he is wrong and he's sorry. That's what she said.
He is, oh God. Okay. Okay. Okay, so here we go again. Not even acknowledging that the comment, okay, let me repeat the comment. The comment that Gator posted, well, oh my God, this is, yo, you can't, we can't make this up, y'all. I'm just letting y'all know. This is, we can't make this up. This is real live stuff right here. We cannot make this up. We can't make this up. So please do not think that we are making this up, because this is real life stuff right here. Okay, now, the comment that Gator posted was, ladies, repeat after me. I, not him, not he, I was wrong. That whole first part got straight ignored and rearranged. They went straight to, I'm sorry. Everybody so far in the comments started off with, I'm sorry, he was wrong. I'm sorry, he was wrong. Like, what? No, 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 no. It says, repeat after me. Not repeat part of what I said. Not repeat, I'm sorry. It says, ladies, repeat after me. When you repeat after somebody, you normally repeat word for word what they said.
Yeah.
You don't choose what part you want to repeat. See, that right there just shows how women feel they gonna do what they gonna do. You telling me to repeat after you, I'm gonna repeat what I wanna repeat. And you just gonna take it. You just gonna take it for what it is.
Yeah.
It clearly says, ladies, repeat after me. That just was like, okay, whatever. Yo. This is funny. It's funny, but it's crazy. It's funny, but it's crazy. Oh my gosh. Okay, so she said
I'm sorry. The next one said, he is wrong and he's sorry.
He is wrong and he is sorry. Wow. So that's a double whammy. That's a double whammy. Yeah.
So I said, oh my God, you read it wrong. And she said, no. She said, no, somebody must have wrote it wrong.
Oh,
she said it must have been a man.
Oh my God. You see this? You see this? Yo, you see this? She looked at the comment, read it, and then said the comment was wrote wrong. Like, who does that? Who does that? You're reading what was wrote. What are you?
I'm just saying.
Oh my God. We can't make this up, people. We cannot make this up. So, okay, so he was wrong and he's sorry. So first off, you're not even admitting that you're wrong. You're automatically saying he was wrong. Let's start there. Not even admitting you were wrong. He was wrong. And now you're saying he's wrong and he's the sorry one. You ain't even sorry. that you wrong. Like, you ain't even sorry you wrong.
You gotta make you wrong first to say that you're sorry for it, though.
That's what I'm right. Exactly. So she just flipped it off. She's not wrong. She's not sorry. He's wrong and he's sorry. Damn. I want to know the brother she talking about. I feel bad for the bro.
I don't know. Cause
I feel bad for the bro, man. Like, I would love to know the guy she talking about and get him to call into the cave. Like, bro, tell us the story. We want to hear this. Listen, we want to hear the story. We will allow the brother in the cave. My guy, if you're listening, if you know the woman that responded to the comment that Gator posted, if you know her and you was the guy in that situation, or if you know the guy that was in that situation, yo, give him our contact here at TDR the Man K. We would love to get him on the air. I want to hear the guy's story, man.
And I'm just on my page. Like, I ain't even checking Instagram or,
oh my God. You know, yo, check it, Gator.
There's no telling.
While we check it live while we here, we got to get to the bottom of this on all there's angles. No, like, we need to really, we got to get to the bottom of this on all angles, because I'm sorry to tell you, ladies, you are not always right. Honestly, it's a lot of times you're not right. And it's and you may feel that you're right, or feel that, oh yeah, I was right. And it's a lot of times us as men, we just don't want to hear it. We don't want to deal with it. We just want peace. Yeah. We ain't trying to deal with the drama. We ain't trying to deal with the 2 and 3 nights of being upset and not getting dinner cooked for us and coming in the household. We ain't trying to deal with all that craziness. So we just, you know, okay, baby, no problem. You're right. So I'm just letting you know, I'm the cat's out the bag. If you didn't know, a lot of times your man is saying it because we don't want to deal with the nonsense. But it's a lot of times you're not right. It's a lot of times y'all be on some bullshit. Yeah, they quiet. They quiet.
Quiet over there.
They real quiet. They real quiet. But you know what? My inboxes went off about 2 times. I really want to see what that's about or whatever. My inboxes, as we live, my inboxes went off about twice.
I don't think you're ready.
Oh, yeah, I'm ready. I want all smoke. Listen, I want all smoke. Let me say something. Any comments that y'all have, any concerns, any questions, anything you want to talk about that, you know, that I said or Gator said or, you know, that was said in the cave, please send all your comments to tonedeafnetwork@gmail.com. tonedeafnetwork@gmail.com. Tone will forward the emails to me. I'll get them and I will respond. You know why? Because that's what I do. That's what I do. Hmm. Yeah. I keep it funky. Yeah. Keep it, you know, straight real. Yeah, I keep it 100. Straight raw, no Vaseline, you know. Straight raw. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I don't know no other way to be. Hey, I just tell the truth. It is what it is. Tell the truth. It is what it is. Gotta have thick skin. You don't have thick skin, hey. Can't take it, get out the kitchen. I'm sorry. Not my problem. But anyway.
That's not my problem.
No problem. I was just saying, man, a lot of people, you know, could talk it, but they can't take it. You know, they can't take criticism or they can't take the truth, you know. And you know, I've never been one to sugarcoat anything. Like, if you ask me a question, I'm gonna give you the truth. If you, you know, so, yeah.
I've been told I can't handle certain things.
Were you been told what? Say that again?
I can't handle certain stuff. But
you can't handle certain things. Okay.
I blame my Scorpio. I blame my Scorpio. Yeah.
You blame the Scorpio. You a Scorpio?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, you
November
know what?
November 17th, I'm an early Scorpio, but still.
You know what? It's funny you say, I blame the Scorpio too, because it's like, y'all are crazy mix. I'm going to tell you. Y'all are crazy mix, man. Like, y'all sensitive, but y'all, y'all sensitive, y'all sensitive, but y'all rowdy.
Oh, yeah.
If that makes sense. You know what I'm saying? Like, y'all sensitive on people telling you certain things, but y'all quick to pop off. So it's like, damn, like, you got to be careful how you talk to a Scorpio.
Like, really?
Right.
Oh, we can do this now.
Right. You got to be careful how you talk to a Scorpio, man. Like, for real. I blame the Scorpio too, there, Gator. I didn't know you were Scorpio,
I blame Scorpio too. I've been told a few times. You just can't take nothing. Like, what?
Yes.
But yeah, it's usually for real. It's coming from my siblings or my parents.
Okay. I got you.
What else?
I understand. I got you. Okay. I don't know. See, I'm an Aquarius. So we're a little different too. We're very. I've been told a lot, and that's other Aquariuses.
Get along, man.
Yeah,
Because I do see I get along with Aquarius.
Yeah. We're a different breed. Not everybody, for real, not everybody know how to take an Aquarius. Like,
yeah.
A lot of people, we're misunderstood a lot, for real. We're misunderstood that a lot of people don't know how to take us, and we're like, we're told, and I know I've been told this a lot too, that I'm very distant.
Yeah.
I'm very distant. You know, like, I have no problem being in my own space, doing my own thing. Like, you know, and we are. But it's like, there's no in between when it comes to us. Aquariuses, you either on my good side or you on my bad side. There's no middle.
See, that's the same way we are. See?
Mm-hmm. It's no middle.
Yeah. Either you in or you out. You
know? That's it. If I don't fuck with you, I'm not fucking with you. Like, I'm not gonna be around you. Right. I'm not gonna be around you and I'm in a room and like, oh yeah, you know I don't fuck with them over there. No. If I don't fuck with you, I'm not fucking with you, point blank, period. That's it. But if I fuck with you, I fuck with you till the wheels fall off.
Yeah. Yeah. Hard. Like,
yeah, it's just that simple. It's just that simple. Man, I got family members I don't fuck with, haven't spoke with in years. I don't give a damn that we got the same blood flowing through our veins. I don't fuck with you. Leave me alone.
Bruh.
I don't care. I don't, man. My kids, and you know, I'm so bad like that, bro, that my kids know it. My kids be like, yo, damn, Dad, you ain't got no problem cutting nobody off. I don't.
I'm just saying.
I don't.
We just get fucked over a lot. That's all.
Yeah, that's all.
It's like when you do, you know how to cut it off because we go to the stream.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
That's what I've been told. Man, you go to the way left.
Yep.
Why you can't just do this?
Like, nope.
Nah, bro. Nah.
Nah. I'm not doing that.
That's just like with my attitude.
Uh-huh.
People know not to get me upset. They know it.
Right.
Don't get me upset.
Right.
At the same time, they always talking about, you always got a smile on your face. You always mm-hmm. doing this and you always doing that.
Mm-hmm.
I had an incident Sunday, right?
Okay.
So everybody know I've been going through my situations and stuff.
Right,
and
right.
I went to church.
Okay.
And I was at church, and one of the elders, he an older gentleman, but he an elder at the church.
Okay.
Came up to me and said, man, you will never talk to me no more. We don't have conversations. We don't do this.
Wow.
We don't do that. And I was like, man, you just don't know how the fuck I'm feeling right now. I don't want to even fucking be here.
Right. You see what I'm saying?
I said See? That in church.
Right.
And his eyes got burnt.
Like, oh, like, shit.
Oh, okay. God bless you. And he walked away.
Right.
He walked away. He was looking like, oh, ooh.
Wow.
And I didn't even think about it till after the fact. And I was like, oh, shoot. I'm like, damn.
I'm not in the place to be talking like that to an elder. My bad. Like, I just had a moment.
I was looking at somebody. Well, I got it's a fan page for my music, but mm-hmm. I use it for doing my shows and stuff too. And this girl that sings with this group, I ain't gonna say who she is because everybody know who she is. And she went on her page and she said that she was at church and she said the elderly people, the elders, they need to chill out because they feel like they can say whatever they want to say to you and you're not supposed to say that back. So she said she was sitting on the chair on the pew or whatever and mm-hmm. she was rubbing her legs because her legs was hurting. And the elderly lady walked up to her and said, what's wrong with you? Why are you rubbing your legs? She was like, because they hurt. And mm-hmm. something, I forget what she said. She said something. The older lady told her, she said, well, you know, you shouldn't be carrying all that weight on them little short legs.
Oh.
And she said she wanted to say something so bad, but if she did, she would be wrong for it.
Right.
But they feel like they can say whatever they want to us.
Oh,
and
man, see.
And say nothing back. She was oh, I wanted to say something so bad.
Oh, God, see. Yeah, that's true, man. They be saying some wild stuff. You're just supposed to sit there. You're supposed to sit there and let Miss Teresa or Miss Angela and Miss Stephanie just sit there and talk crazy and you like word
you
like
shouldn't
okay.
be carrying all that weight on them little legs.
All that weight on those little oh no. Completely wrong. That's completely wrong.
And the way that she told it on her page, I was
completely
crying.
Wrong. Wow.
But you could tell, like, she was like, ooh.
Wow. Yeah, that's not even a poke. That's a straight stab. Like, she didn't even poke. She just straight stabbed her, like, all that weight on those little legs. Like, what the hell, bro? Whoa.
And she was, to me, she ain't no big girl.
Right.
Like
she's curvy.
She's not big. Yeah.
Yeah, she curvy.
And so I was like, wow, I don't even know what I was saying.
See. Oh man. See that's when I don't know. See, now
and
is that a moment
feel about they weighed us as
right.
weird, though.
That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying. Look, I felt you know us as men, you got to be very sensitive about what you say about a woman's weight.
Bruh.
Like, listen, I'm not even going to bring that topic up. Like, if you don't bring it up, I'm not bringing it up.
I ain't that bold.
If you don't bring it up, I ain't bringing it up. Exactly. Like, and when you bring it up, I'm going to act dumb at first.
I'm like, my life too much.
Right. You bring it up, I'm gonna act dumb at first. What weight, babe? What you talking about? You're gonna have to ask that question the second time. I'm not even gonna touch that. Don't do it. Leave that alone.
Nah, this other comment talking about I was wrong about thinking that the person was sincere. I'm sorry, saying it to myself. Okay. Then you got another homeboy that posted it that I got mm-hmm. on his page. He said, I hope you have better luck than me.
See that? Do you see? Man, you know what? I'm going to post that on my page. I'm going to post that on my page right now. You know what? While we live, I'm going to post this on my page right now.
Another guy said, laugh out loud, it'll never happen, friend. Hadn't met a woman yet who's capable of admitting it when she's wrong.
I'm posting this right on my page. I'm posting this right on my page now. So that's two. You mean to tell me you and another guy posted this and neither one of y'all had luck?
None.
That's a doggone shame.
I see another one that's on here that said, I have no issues admitting when I'm wrong. Contrary to popular belief, women don't know it all. We actually do fuck up too. And that tripped me out. Like, wait, what?
Wow. Hold up. What?
So my homeboy went on her. We was talking on her post, and my homeboy said, oh my God, where have you been? And then he asked me, who is this woman on your wall, bro? She can't be a real person.
She can't be. She can't be real. That's a robot. That's a robot. That was scripted. Like,
nah, I've known her for 2 years. And then, look, then there's another woman come on my post.
Okay.
Me and her go at it all the time. We be joking and talking about different stuff because I be causing controversy. She gonna say, man, repeat after me. Yes, I lied, and I'm sorry. I'll pack my shit. So I go, here you go. Why are you trying to turn things around?
Mm-hmm.
She said, first, she said, I didn't turn it around. I just put it back the way it should have been.
Oh. You see that?
Bruh.
Wow. See, once again, there it goes to just disregarding what the actual comment is
and making it their own.
And you see, that's what trips me out, because they'll be wrong, but they will then take what you feel is wrong about what they did, and they will turn it into why they are actually right. You see what I'm saying? Like, it's the Jedi mind trick, man. I'm telling you, and a lot of you got a lot of guys out there that be falling for it, man. They be under that spell. They be under that spell. Get out the spell, brothers. Do not look her directly in the eyes. This
the
is
last
bullshit.
Comment on there, I said.
Yeah, let's keep it going.
She go, wait, what did we do? And I said, apparently nothing. I see y'all never apologize.
Oh my
gosh. She just started laughing, right?
Oh my gosh.
So I was like,
oh my gosh.
You know what? I'm done. You know what? It's not going to happen. And that was just on my page.
Oh my gosh.
I put it a few places. And on this one, on another one I see, the first comment is, shit, I forgive you. Thanks for admitting it. What?
Wow.
Another woman said, you was wrong. You're sorry. Another one said, it takes a big man to admit when he's wrong. Like, what?
Wow.
I just told him I'm ashamed of all of them. I'm just ashamed.
Oh, my gosh.
One of the guys in the group said, now, you know this wasn't going to work. This was not going to work.
Oh, my gosh. Well, I just posted this on my page. I just posted it, and I put in the caption, how many women can actually do this? So I added on to it.
Good luck.
Yeah, I'm going to see how much luck I have. Hopefully I get some responses. Hopefully I get some responses kind of quickly. How many women actually do this? How many women actually do this? And then I got the comment.
I put it on my personal page, dude. And the first comment I got, it says, not going to happen.
Wow.
My first, I posted it on my like page when we started the show. Not go half. I got 5 laughing emojis.
Wow. Really? Really? See, 5. This is, that's crazy. Sure.
Let me see.
That's crazy.
Let me make sure before I say this. 1, 2, 3. 4 to 5 women. I mean, 4 to 5 laughing emojis are women.
Mm-hmm. You said 4 to 5 laughing emojis what?
Are women.
Oh, they ain't comment. See, yeah.
They just comment. They just
laugh. Emojis. They laugh like it's funny to them. Like, ha, ha, ha. Ha, ha, ha. Whatever. I'm never wrong.
Hilarious.
Oh, my gosh. This is crazy. This is bad. This is bad.
That's all the guys. All the guys say good luck.
Yeah. Yeah. Good, because you're going to need it. You're going to need it. You're trying to get a woman to admit that she's wrong. You're going to be there a long time. Why you think you be having them old grumpy men been married for like 15 years and they don't even try to argue with their wife no more? You be seeing them.
Nah.
And you be seeing them. And the wife just be going off. She just be talking a mile a minute, this, that. And the old dude just be sitting there looking numb. Like, he just be looking in the space like, mm-hmm. And we be saying, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, babe. Yep. Mm-hmm. All right, babe. Yep. He got so damn programmed to this shit that that's how he responds to everything. Yep. Mm-hmm. All right, babe. Yep. Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Damn shade. They turn us into zombies, man. They turn into old zombies. Don't make no sense.
It's bad, dog.
Bad, man. Bad. Bad business, man. This is not.
I don't understand.
Not the way it's supposed to be.
Why women can't admit when they wrong? What's the problem? Like,
I don't know, man. They just refuse to.
Like they said, you know, it's when they coming up, but is it a woman law? Like, you
it's
know,
in
we
their
got
book.
Man laws.
Yeah, we got man law.
is that a woman law?
Like, we got the black book. We got the black book, and they got the purple book. It's in the purple book. It's in the purple. We got the black book. They got the purple book. Never admit that you're wrong.
I'm just trying to.
Yeah.
Admitting you're
part
wrong.
Of their loss.
Admitting you're wrong shows weakness. I just see that. Like,
there you go. Don't ever let him feel that he's inferior over you. Shows weakness. You're never wrong. Never admit to that. Yeah, I can see that. I definitely can see that. He's trying to take away your independence, you know.
Bruh,
shit like
you,
that.
I tag you and Tom. So y'all can see these comments on this post. Because I just knew.
Damn shame. That's a damn shame. I'm still, I'm still stuck that you posted this in 3 different groups and you only got 1 woman.
Actually, now I see it's 2. What? No, it's 3. I see 3 women now.
Mm, but, okay.
You know, like
they're probably listening to the show.
This is among about 40-something comments.
Uh-huh.
So, you know, it's still like...
Yeah.
I mean, it ain't 10%.
It's still I didn't say 10. I said 5.
Yeah, 5%. Yeah, yeah. I don't know, bro.
Yeah. It's like, know. It's 5. I said 5, but you know what? It's not looking good. It's just not looking good. It's not looking good for the women.
I wonder if there's a difference when you married.
No,
I'm trying
there
to
isn't.
Remember.
No.
I'm trying to remember.
No.
If I was
no.
Right.
No. I'm here to tell you I was once down that path.
I'm just
no.
Saying, I'm trying to remember if I
no.
was right. Like,
the only thing that changes is now you're legally binded to them for them to tell you why they're not wrong.
You know, you might have... I think I might have been right a couple of times, but it was right around the time that my paycheck hit.
man. Oh, shit. By the time you got paid, huh? Oh, shit. Yeah, you right. You right. Uh-huh, yeah. Today Friday, right? Today Friday, right? Yeah, you right. You right, babe. You right, babe. Yup, you right, babe. You know what? I don't even know why we arguing. Uh-huh. Shit like that. That's a damn shame. And then the next day, your ass wrong again. You wrong and broke. Wrong and broke.
Oh, wow.
Next day.
I see somebody saying, I'm wrong, and I'm sorry. Can I get some dick now? What?
Oh. Well, you know what? That is one of the times.
Okay, mm-hmm. See, that's in the black men don't cheat group. See?
Yeah. Wow. See? 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 That what? Is one of the times a woman will admit they wrong when they want some pleasure.
They want to reciprocate something.
Yeah, when they want some pleasure, when it's like, listen.
I just said
I need
days,
you
but...
right now. Yep. They will admit that.
She just made my point.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she sure did. She got to get something up to do. It's like, oh, okay, so you want me to admit I'm wrong? Okay, well, what's in it for me? What's in it for me? Oh, okay, you gonna give me the D? Oh, yeah, I'm wrong, baby. I'm wrong. See that?
That's crazy.
Gotta be something in the deal for her. Gotta that's be something crazy. In the deal. Look, I ain't even get a response yet. Nobody even responded to my shit. They looking at it.
You see they looking at it, ain't nobody saying
they,
that.
They ain't even respond. They looking at that shit like, Cal, you tripping. Like, Cal, you tripping. You really think that we going to respond to this shit? That's a damn shame. They ain't even responding. I see they see that shit. A damn shame. No respect. No respect. No respect, oh, man. This is bad. This is bad. That's women, we got to talk about this. You know what? We're going to do a part two to this, and with Clarissa. We're gonna do a part two of this, and we're gonna have Clarissa on the phone, and maybe she could give us some insight because we lost. We don't know what the hell. Like, this is something that every man has been dealing with for years, all the way back to Egypt. You know, we've been dealing with this since the pharaohs, and this has been, you know, the queen going through the kingdom, and just don't want to admit that she was wrong. So we need some clarity from a woman, and we definitely gonna do a part two to this with Clarissa, and you know she could probably give us some insight on this because then we can express to her why women are wrong at times, and you know that'd be a very interesting discussion.
Right.
That'd be an interesting discussion. You know, me and Clarissa will, you know, probably bump heads and, you know, mm-hmm. go back and forth. But Clarissa, she's real. For those who don't know, who didn't listen to last week's show, Clarissa is, one of the co-hosts, our newest co-host on Tone Deaf Network. So she joined us in the Man Cave last week, and it was a very great show. If you didn't get a chance to listen to it, please tune in. You know, please, it's on all your major platforms, Spotify, iHeart, Spreaker, Google Play. It's everywhere, you know. Go check out TDR, The Man Cave, and also go listen to all the rest of the shows on Tone Deaf Network as well. You know, we got a lot of great shows, The Breakdown, you know, The Deaf Fresh Show, Hostly Awkward. You know, we have a lot of good, Real Bar Talk. A lot of good shows that we have on the network. So definitely go check out our shows, support the other co-hosts as well. And of course, you know, you can definitely check out The Man Cave. Last show was a great show with co-host Clarissa. So definitely go check that out. So we're definitely going to do a part two to this and, have Clarissa on the show so she could give us some insight from a woman's point of view because, we don't understand why they just don't get it.
The lady that said, "Can I get some dick now?" Said the reason she said that, it's true because she be playing the game. That's the way for her to get him off the game.
Wow. So let's break this down. Let's break that down. Let's break this down a little bit. So she is forcefully going to say that she's wrong, even though she doesn't feel she's wrong. So she can interrupt his downtime. She can interrupt his downtime, his stress-free time, playing his game, you know, getting his mind off the world's pressure and what he had to deal with. And, you know, it's his free time just so she can get pleasure how she wants. That see how she's still not admitting, still not admitting she's wrong. She's false accusations as far as admitting she's wrong when she feels she isn't. You know, she's also taking him away from his mental downtime. So she's being selfish just to get what she wants. In a wrongful, and she's being triple wrong. That's triple wrong. triple insane, wrong. Man. That's a T-Dub, triple wrong. Oh my gosh. You see this? And she would justify this like, shit, I want some dick. Like, what about being honest? You see how they always tell us how about honesty and just tell me the truth and why you gotta this. And if you just tell me the truth, when they can't even admit to being wrong, where's the truth in that?
Your guess is as good as mine.
I just, I'm over here scratching my bald head and I just don't understand. I don't know. See, it's a mystery. It's just going to be another mystery in the woman's book, you know. Yeah, I don't get it, Gata. This is the one show that we will bring to an end and we don't have an answer. This is the one show out of all of our 50 plus shows that we have done thus far on the Man Cave.
Ladies,
we always
if y'all listening, go to Facebook, like the like page, and answer the question.
Answer the question, because we done did about how many shows we done so far. This is about 59, I think 60. We around there somewhere. We about 59, 60 shows in. Around there. I believe this might be 60. This is our 60th show. And out of all 59 shows, we've always come to a conclusion. This is the first show we don't have an answer. We just don't have an answer. We you know.
Hilarious.
It's sad, Gator. It's sad. Sad. It's just sad. It's purely sad. They how they use their womanly ways and sexual ways to still not admit they're wrong. Sad.
Well, I knew it wasn't gonna happen anyway, but I don't know.
It's sad. It's just sad. I
was giving them the benefit of the doubt, but
no, you can't give the benefit of the doubt. You can't give the benefit of the doubt when to them it ain't even no damn doubt that they not wrong. Ain't no doubt that they not wrong. I mean, where's the benefit at? Ain't no benefit. Only person benefiting is they ass.
They offended like I said something wrong.
Yeah. Like you lying or saying something that's not right.
Hey,
look,
I don't know.
Now I done posted this about 20 minutes ago. I still ain't got a damn comment. goddamn comment, man. And that's not normal for my page, man. I normally post something in a matter of minutes. People commenting, liking.
They be flying.
Right. Yo, I don't have a thumbs up. I don't have a heart. I don't even have a laugh. They ain't even laughing at my shit. They just ain't even responding. It's just like, whatever, Cal, you tripping tonight.
I don't know what he been smoking.
You know what I'm saying? Better leave that Hennessy alone. Got you tripping tonight. Talking about how many women will actually do this. Cal, you crazy. That's a damn shame. I'm laughing, but it's sad, ladies. I'm laughing, but the shit is sad. It's sad, damn it. God damn it, it's sad. You know what? From now on, I'm not admitting when I'm wrong. How about that? Nah, let me stop. That shit get me kicked out. That shit get my ass kicked out. I ain't taking it that far, though. Hold on. Let me bring that back a little bit. Let me bring that back. Hold on. Let me bring that back. I ain't that crazy. Shit. I'll be calling up Tone and Gator talking about, yo, bro, I'm coming over. Coming over, man. Yeah, she over here tripping. She over here tripping, man. I'm just coming over for a little minute.
Oh, she's going to be in the background. He's lying. I ain't tripping. Word. He's tripping.
Exactly. Exactly, man. Shit, hold on. I ain't trying to get kicked out of the happy home now. I ain't trying to fucking happy home now. Shit, god damn it. You know what I'm saying? I may be real, but I ain't crazy. Bullshit, man. It's a bullshit, though, man. Sorry, though. We going to get Carissa. Carissa going to give us some insight on this because we need to know. We need a woman's opinion. You need a woman's opinion. This is serious. Starts from young and it just goes on. It just goes on. I don't get it, man. Don't know. I don't know. But how was your week, Gator? Like let's get off that topic for a little minute because we ain't even got an answer. We ain't got an answer. I don't know.
My week been all right, though. Okay. There's no answer coming.
Answer. Moving on. We done spent over an hour. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Well, I do it. Because she wanted to get something out of it.
There you go. That's it. That's the answer.
That's the closest answer.
They will admit when they wrong. When there's something there's something in it for them. Bam. That's the answer. That's the sorry ass answer.
I'll take it, because that's all we're going to get.
We ain't got a choice, man. That's the sorry ass answer, man, to this. That's a damn shame. That's a damn shame.
She was being serious, too. She was like, yo, I do it. Get him off this
gang. Yeah. Dead serious, too. And the sad part about it is, she'll probably convince the motherfucker that she wasn't wrong in the middle of sex. Because you know, you'll get a nigga to admit to anything while you giving him the cookie. Weak. That's our weakest moment.
Tragedy.
It's the truth. I hate to say it, but fellas, it's the truth. That's our weakest moment. Your lady can get anything out of you when she giving you that peach. When she giving you that good, you, man, you'll say anything, you'll do anything. It's just, and you do it without even second guessing. Yeah, babe. She's like, yeah. So, yeah, you know, you're going to give me the keys to your Benz tomorrow, right? Yeah, babe, you can have the keys. Yeah, I'll give you the keys. No problem.
You think that's how Eve made Apple? Never mind.
Hell yeah, that's how Eve made Adam eat that damn apple. Matter of fact, yeah, let's talk about that, god damn it. Because that's another situation of a woman using her womanly goods to get a man to do some shit that was so wrong.
Because you do so, know the serpent
God said,
eat.
Do not eat. God said of Almighty, look, Almighty, the Most High, the guy that made the thunder, the lightning, the land, the trees, the sun, the one that made both of y'all. Adam, let me tell you, look, this is how deep. Adam watched God make Eve. He watched him. He seen him at work. He seen him like, oh, man, like, yo, this he just made another human. What? Like, he seen him at work. But yet, even still, Adam knowing the power of the Most High, Eve, he still allowed the woman to use her womanly goods to get him to eat from the one tree. You can eat anything you want. You can have anything you want except for on that tree. And Eve said, why? Instead of just listening to God, she said, well, why can't I eat off that tree? Because I said so. Don't eat off the tree. Well, I mean, what if I want to eat off the tree? What if I see an apple on there that I just want to eat? Maybe I might not want no grass or no, you know, anything over here. I want to eat from the tree. Eve, don't eat from the tree. You can eat anywhere else but the tree. Well, I'm just saying, I might want to eat from the tree. Eve, don't eat from the tree. Okay, if you say so, but I might want it one day. Here come Adam, dumbass. He come walking and shit, just came home from work. He tired and shit. You know, he just want to kick back and, you know, maybe just watch the sunset, you know, talk to this lady about his day. She in the house whole day wondering how.
About that.
You see what I'm saying? Thinking you look at it, you know what I mean? He just want to kick it with his lady. She in the house all day wondering how could she get Adam to get her an apple from the tree and God not know that it was her, because she want to know why she just can't eat from that tree. It's going in her brain. It's going all in her all day. That's all she could think about. Adam not knowing that God had a conversation, full conversation with Eve, told her not to eat from the tree, leave the tree alone. Adam know that the tree's off limits. God told him long time ago before Eve even got there. So Adam not even worried about the tree. He ain't worried about the tree. He don't even care about the tree because he can eat whatever the hell he wants except for that tree. So
think
Adam
about
like
how many other trees was in the garden of fruit.
Right.
Like
so Adam like it don't matter to Adam. So Adam like, okay, no problem. I can eat whatever I want except for that tree. All right, whatever. I'm good. It don't matter to me. But a woman thinks otherwise. The minute you tell them they can't do that, you done did something completely wrong. I can't. It ain't about I can't, because I can, and guess what? I will. Just because you said that I can't. Just because you said I can't, I'm going to do it. And guess what? You ain't even going to know I did it.
That's crazy.
That's what it all boils down to. So now she and Adam air. He just came home from work. He tired, chicken back. She all in his ear about this tree. Now, first thing, Adam thinking like, nah, we can't mess with that. Leave that alone. Like, nah, you know, listen, God done told me long time ago, God gonna trip. I'm not trying to get into it with big guy. That's my boy. That's my OG. I ain't trying to get into it with him. We got everything we need except for that tree. What's such the big deal? Ain't he taking care of us? He eating, he making sure we eat. He got it all. He getting it all. So he making sure we eat, we straight. That little folky tree, that's the one thing you tripping right now, babe. I don't even like apples. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't even like apples. I don't even like apples. Like, I like oranges. I like grapes. I don't even like apples. You trip? Matter of fact, babe, when the last time I seen you eat an apple? When the last time I seen you eat an apple? You don't even like apples like that. Like, come on, cut the shit. Like, I just came home trying to chill with you, trying to have some romance time, and you all in my ear about these damn apples on that crusty ass tree. Yo, I mean, like, same, come on, man. Now. But now he's saying that, right? So now she getting defensive. Now she going flipping on him. Oh, so you don't care about if I want an apple. So now it's all about what you want. Oh, so you scared of God? You scared of him? You scared of him? Oh, I thought you was the man of the house. Oh, you scared of him. You scared because he told you we can't have the apples. So you soft now. I thought you was the man. Now she attacking his manhood. So you just going to tell him, you just going to let him tell you what to do, huh? In your household. You going to let him tell you. Oh, so because she telling
rolling
you.
Rolling her neck and everything.
Rolling her neck, snapping her fingers. He just going to tell you. Well, guess what? If you ain't man enough to stand up to God, I'm not going to have him tell me what to do. So I'm going to go get the apple, you know, and I'm going to enjoy the apple. Because since you so scared of your OG, like, this don't make no sense. I cook, I clean, I take care of you. So now, you know, as a man, you feel attacked. Your manhood is attacked. Now you start talking shit that you know you shouldn't be talking. You talk, oh, well, you know what? You right, yo. OG do be tripping sometime. Like, it ain't even that serious. Like, I mean, I ain't that tree been there for a minute. Those apples probably are good. They've been sitting there for a while. So they probably real right. You know what, babe? You right. Man. Fuck that. Yo, I'm my own man. I ain't got to listen to nobody. I'm my own man. I pay my own bills. I can eat whatever I want. You know what I'm saying? He ain't going to be clowning me like that. He probably trying to make me a fool. He go get the damn apple. She feed it to him, and now shit all fucked up.
Oh, she wrote.
See that? All because she couldn't admit to her truth.
Nice.
Bam. See that? There we go. Now we got a conclusion.
That's it right there.
We done got the damn conclusion. See, I wasn't going to end this show till we got a damn conclusion. Answer. You know, damn, we get a conclusion every week. See what I'm saying? See what I'm saying, women? It's y'all fault. It's y'all fault. Sorry. Hate to break it to you like that. That's what it is. See, I'm good now. Now I can pour me a glass of Hennessy. You know what I'm saying? Kick back.
Send all your emails.
All my emails. I got an inbox. I got an inbox.
Uh-oh.
Cal, you stupid. That's all it says. Cal, you stupid. Yeah, got another one. You are really trying to compare Adam and Eve to why women don't admit when they're wrong.
Hey.
Hey.
I was
works.
Just wondering, because, you know, I mean, be a Bible thumper. I had to think about it. Like, wait. I wonder if that came into play.
Yep, it sure did. Sure did. It sure did. It sure did. You're right about that. Okay, somebody else said, I enjoy your hood version of Adam and Eve. But it did have some truth to it. The way you broke it down in an urban format. Preach on, brother. That's what I'm talking about. See? Hey.
Man, I'm thinking, you know, because, you know, the serpent did go to Eve.
That's right.
Like, I know how to get them.
That's right.
I'm going to go talk to Eve. Because, quote unquote, people say that's the weakest sex. I don't believe it, but that's what they say. So, yeah, I'm gonna go talk to Eve. Eve,
because you know why
he had already tried Adam.
And that's what I'm about to say. You know why? He been, look, how long Adam was there before Eve even came? You think that was the first time the serpent came around talking shit?
Nah.
He been trying to get at Adam for years.
Nah.
It's just like this. Check it. It's just like this. You shining, you getting money, right? You shining, you getting money, you getting money. You know what I'm saying? You doing your thing. You living your best life. Then you got your boy, you got Ty from down the block. Always trying to get you to go against your partner, Jay. He in your ear day in and day out. You need to come fuck with him. Yo, get rid of Jay. You know what I'm saying? We don't need him. You could be shining and doing bigger things over here for years with me, man. You keep messing with Jay, and you need to come over here and mess with me. You know what I'm saying? Your boy Ty, man. I'm getting it. You loyal. You like, nah. Then the minute you start messing with Tiffany, you messing with Tiffany from the block. She messing with you hard. She feeling your style. Now, Tiffany, she knew Ty for a minute too. So it's like a mutual friend. You know what I mean? So Ty know he can't get to you. You so loyal to Jay. He been trying to get you to come over to his side for a minute. Now he know Tiffany, your girl. He know Tiffany for a little minute. So now he say he can't be trying to get to you for years. It ain't worked. So he going to go holler at Tiff and be like, yo, Tiff, man, tell your man to come over here and mess with me. He keep messing with Jay. You know what I mean? He can eat more over here with me. Now, your girl, Tiffany, don't really know Jay like that. She know that Jay your man, but she know Ty. So now she getting in your ear, slowly but surely. Yo, you know Ty getting it. I know Jay your man, but you might be able to get more over there with Ty. You might be able to run your own stuff. Jay holding you back. It ain't going to sink at the beginning, but eventually it's going to start playing in your ear. Well, yeah, I do know Ty. I know he winning. You know, I've been wanting to make a couple of moves, but Jay keep telling me the time ain't right. It's not right. Like, we got to, you know, calculate better. This everything going to come in time. We just got to be patient. You know what I'm saying? Nah, I don't want to be patient. I want it now. Ty willing to give it to me now, and my girl co-signing for him. So I know my girl not going to lead me down the road. Way, you know what I mean? I trust my girl. You go fuck with Ty and shit getting that. You go fuck with Ty, and in 2 weeks your ass locked up doing the 3 to 5.
Tragic.
You know what I'm saying? Listen, I could break down any Bible story. You know what I'm saying? In the urban format, man. Give me another one. I'm telling you, I could do it. Look, holla at your boy, man. You need to understand it. Holla at me. I'll break it down for you. Call it hood scriptures, man. Hood scriptures.
Hey, there you go.
Hood scriptures, man. Break it down for you.
New segment on the man cave.
You know what I'm saying? Break down Bible scriptures the hood way, you know what I mean? Oh, God, man. Look. Go have some church phone. I was church folk in my email.
I'm gonna hit that red button.
Togo, give me a scripture for next week. I'm gonna break it down scriptures, man. Bible scriptures the other way. You know what I mean? Feel me? You know what I mean?
Hey, it is.
Break it down, man. Have some angry. So there's gonna be some angry church folk in my inbox talking about. Excuse me, Mr. Cal.
Uh-oh.
You should not be like what? Everybody got to understand the word. Everybody got to understand the word. Not everybody understand the word the way it's written. So this is what I'm a translator. I'm an urban translator. Translator.
Uh-oh.
Translate the word. You know what I'm saying? They might. Some people may not know how to pronunciate Jesus, but they know if I say yo J, that's J. You know what I'm saying? The Most High J. They like, oh, okay, all right. That's how, you know what I'm saying? You got to break it down. You know, you got to let them know.
Hook it up.
Oh, there
it is.
You know what I'm saying? They might not understand when they be like, yo, what you mean by he parted the Red Sea? I'm like, okay, well, check it. You know how, like, when you about to roll up, you know what I'm saying? And you got to break down the roll up in the middle. You know what I'm saying? That's parting. You got to parting, you know what I'm saying, the Dutch, and you know you drop the ashes out, right? So it's like he parting the Red Sea, which means he broke it down in the middle. You see what I'm saying?
All right. I didn't get him to understand that.
It's like, oh, so that's what you mean. He broke it. You know what I mean? You gotta break it down. But I'm going to hell, ain't I, Gator? I'm going to hell, right?
Hey, nobody can hear. But I'm like, I ain't touching it.
Yo, I'm telling you, man, I can break it down. Look, give me some scriptures. I break it down for you. You understand the word more. So when you go to church, you know what I'm saying? Or you go with you read the Bible, the good book, you get the true meaning of what is being trying to be said to you. You know what I mean? You get it. I break it down for you, man. I'm telling you, man. You know what I'm saying? Just like I said, like Solomon. It's like Solomon had many wives. You know what I mean? They people might not understand that. You know what I mean? Like, yo, so I don't understand how he was a king and he had to. I'm like, listen, okay, check it. Solomon, you know how, like, back in the days you had the pimps. You know what I'm saying? And they had women. You know what I'm saying? And, like, so, like, Solomon was like a pimp. You know what I mean? Like, he had women. You know what I mean? So I can break it down for them. You got to really get them to understand it. Like, oh, okay, so Solomon, that's what he mean. Yes. You know what I'm saying? He had women. He had money. He was pimping.
Back then, it was different, too.
Yeah.
That was, man. That was the norm back in the day.
Word. It was. You got to break it down for them. You know what I mean? You got to break it down. Like, oh, well, she cut his hair off and that took away his strength. What did that mean? Okay, so that means, like, you know, she just took his bread. She robbed him. You know what I'm saying? Like, she robbed him of his money. Took his strength from him. You know what I mean? He didn't feel strong no more without his money. You know what I mean? So he fell. You know what I mean? He's fucked up in the game. You know what I mean? Because he didn't have his bread. You know what I mean? And then his woman took his money. And then after that, the rest of the woman left. The rest of his hoes left. Because they like, yo, you a broke pimp. I can't take the word of a broke pimp. You know what I'm saying? You ain't got no money. You know what I mean? So they left.
Oh, God. He was a broke pimp.
You gotta break it down. You gotta break it down to them, man. I'm just saying. I'm just telling y'all, man. See, I bet we got people that's listening that didn't understand those scriptures. You know what I'm saying? And now they got a better understanding of the word. I'm just a messenger. I'm just a messenger. I'm a hood prophet. There you go, Gator. You feel me, Gator? You feel me? This is hood. I'm a hood prophet. You know what I mean? I'm a hood prophet, man. I'm just a messenger, man. I'm just a messenger. You know what I'm saying? That's it.
I'm going to be bad at
Only in the cave, man. Only in the cave, baby. You're going to get this in the cave, man. I'm just telling you. There's no restrictions in the cave, you know. We're not censored, you know. We're not censored. Nah. We're not censored. Okay. Oh, man.
Thank you for joining
us. Thank you for joining us.
We appreciate it.
We do appreciate it. This was a real good show. You know, we finally came to a conclusion on why women don't admit when they wrong. You know what I'm saying? We finally came to a conclusion. It all started with Eve. You know, we got the conclusion. She didn't want to listen to the OG. You know what I mean? Nagging Adam when he came home from work. You know what I'm saying? Making him go get apples. He don't even eat apples off the tree. You know, like, we got a conclusion.
Just saying.
You know, we had a couple of hood scriptures we broke down, you know, for people so they can understand it more. Send me your scriptures. I'll break it down to you, you know, in hood format so you can get it, you know, understand, you know. So, with that being said... Oh, man, y'all stop for real. That being said, I just want to say thank you, everybody, that tuned in to this episode of The Man Cave. You know, got a couple of things done here. Another wild, crazy night is always in the cave. Shout out to Tone for paying the bills and writing those checks. You know, looking forward to those, you know, those deposits, you know, those receivables. So, Tone, you know, I'm going to give you a different account. You can send my receivable to a different account this time. I gotta switch it up. You know, I gotta switch accounts because, you know, I can't say on air because I don't want certain people to hear certain things about that. I'd be real secretive, you know.
We already know.
Hey, yo, shout out to the Young Gunner, Young Fresh. Fresh, what's good, brother? You know. So, and like I, once again, shout out to every show, all the shows on Tone Deaf Network. Like I said, you get a chance, definitely check them out. We everywhere. You never there. Tone Deaf Network, baby. We everywhere. And yo, Gator, you got anything you want to say, brother, before we close out the show?
Hey, good show. Appreciate it. That's all I got to say.
Oh, so you going to hit me with the Russell Simmons? You going to hit me with the Russell Simmons?
I ain't play John Slay.
Yeah. Just hit me with the Russell Simmons, man. Remember that? After every Def Comedy Jam, Martin would get out there. So I guess I'm Martin and you Russell, huh? Martin would get out there. Say a whole bunch of shit. He'd be like, I'm going to hand it over to the man and pay the bills. Yo, Russell. He'd be like, thank you for coming out. Have a good night. Like, what? Russell, say something else, man. He just hit me with the Russell service, man. Oh, man. But, okay, y'all, because, you know, my talkative behind, I keep you here for another hour, but I know people got things they got to do. That's okay. I'm going to get online and talk more shit. Thanks, everybody, for tuning in to another great edition of The Man Cave. I'm your host, Cal Williams, joined by my other host, Gator. And, yo, we had a great night. Without you, there could be no us. Thank you for tuning in and making it great. Man Cave, we out.
Come to the end of the world.